GERD, gastroesophageal reflux disease, is a long-term condition where acid regularly flows up from the stomach into the esophagus. This acid stimulates proteins called cytokines, which are responsible for damaging the lining of the esophagus and plague its victims with heartburn, nausea, bad breath, and pain when swallowing, as well as possible tissue damage. The specialist at Advanced Gastroenterology and Surgery Associates explain GERD and how they treat it.
The most common condition we see in men, I think, would most likely be gastroesophageal reflux disease, especially with increasing obesity. We're seeing more and more cases of acid reflux. And the other reason it's important in men is that there's rising esophageal adenocarcinoma of the esophagus through a condition called Barrett's esophagus, and it's much more common in men than in women. So anyone who has a chronic history of acid reflux should probably have an endoscopy to look to make sure they don't have this change in the lining of the esophagus. If they have this change in the lining, then we do surveillance endoscopies, and that way we can sort of prevent them from developing adenocarcinoma of the esophagus. If you speak to a patient that has had significant acid reflux, significant heartburn in the past, and then they present and say, you know, I don't have that symptoms that much anymore, it actually feels a little bit better, you have to suspect the possibility of Barrett's esophagus, because the body's way of changing the lining of the esophagus to look like the stomach, which can handle acid, so the patients get less symptoms, because the lining has changed to look like the stomach. So it's sort of the body's protecting itself. However, when the cells undergo change, there's a risk of carcinogenesis and developing cancer. So even though the body's trying to protect itself from the symptoms, ultimately it can lead to problems down the road. It actually is a motility disorder. People normally think that it's just acid, but it's just reflux of gastric contents into the esophagus that causes a symptom. We all have transient relaxation of the muscle at the end of the esophagus, so we all get a little bit of reflux. If you eat a pizza or fried foods, fatty foods, you'll get a little bit of reflux. But some people get it much more often. People with hiatal hernias, where part of the stomach is slid up into the chest, tend to be more prone to get acid reflux, and they tend to have more significant problems. The medications, however, that we have actually just control the acid. They don't really prevent the reflux of gastric contents. That's why the anti-reflux measures are very important. So elevating the head of the bed is extremely important. We normally recommend 6 to 8 inches with blocks or a wedge. And of course as well, not lying down after eating, because you want the stomach to empty at least 3 to 4 hours after a meal. You shouldn't lay down, because then you sort of increase the chances of reflux of gastric contents.
For more information on Advanced Gastroenterology and Surgery Associates and their services, please click on the GERD Grief story link icon on our homepage at yourhometownhealth.com.